We continue now at the top of Daf Samech Tes Amud Beis in Maseches Pesachim. This is Pesachim Daf 69b. The Gemara here is in the middle of explaining why Rabbi Eliezer makes a distinction, and he says that somebody who's Tamei, who needs to do Hazah in order to become pure, he's Tamei Mei, so in that case he's considered not fit for Karban Pesach at all, and therefore the Hazah is not going to push off Shabbos. Let's say Erev Pesach falls out on Shabbos. On the other hand, somebody who is an Aril in that situation, the person is considered fit to bring Karban Pesach, and really he does need to get himself a Bris Milah in order to be able to bring Karban Pesach, and the Gemara here continues to explain. The rule is, if you have a type of situation of Tumah where an individual is pushed off, meaning he cannot bring the Karban Pesach in that kind of Tumah, so if the whole Tzibur would have that kind of Tumah, they do it B'Tumah. Now, anything which a tzibur can do, isa biyachid, that's going to apply to a yachid as well, as we're going to explain. And if it's something that does not apply in the situation of a tzibur, lesa biyachid, it will not apply by the yachid as well. And so now, Rabbi Eliezer explains the distinction. Arelus, when it comes to Aril, the ikule tzibur arelim ninu, if the entire tzibur would be arelim, so amrin and lohu, we would tell them, kumu maholin afshaychu ve'avidi pischa, we would say, everybody get a brismila and everybody do Karban Pesach. You can't bring Karban Pesach as arelim. So yachin nami, so that's why when it comes to the individual also, amrin and lay, we say to him, kul mol, kumu mol, get up and do a brismila, ve'avid pischa, and do the Karban Pesach, ve'ilo mol, ve'avid onish karis. If you don't do the bris milah, and if you don't take care of it, you're going to get kares. But when it comes to tumah, the ikule tzibura tamei ininu, if the entire tzibur would be tamei, loma dinan alai, we're not going to purify them, ela avdi b'tumah, they just bring the Karban Pesach b'tumah. So yachid nami pater, so that's why yachid also is considered to be pater, the chiyav is not considered to be upon the person, and that's why there's a distinction between if a person is an orel or if a person is tamei. So amar le Rav Huna b'reid Rav Yoshua l'rava, so Rav Huna, the son of Rav Yoshua, said to Rava, what are you talking about? Varei Pesach Sheni, what about Pesach Sheni? The lesei b'tzibur, the tzibur does not do Pesach Sheni, because again, when it comes to a tzibur, if they're, let's say, all tamei, they just do a Pesach Rishon b'tumah. So they don't do Pesach Sheni. V'isei b'yachid, yet an individual does do Pesach Sheni. If there's an individual who is tamei, who couldn't bring Karban Pesach and Pesach Rishon, he does Pesach Sheni. So you see that there are situations where a yachid will have Karban Pesach and the tzibur will not. So Amar Lei said to him, no, Shani Hasim, it's different over there. To ha'avid le tzibura b'rishon, the only reason an individual can do Pesach Sheni is because the tzibur did the Karban Pesach b'rishon, so that's why it's okay. And Rashi over here explains. Amar Lei said to him, Hasam hai di'isei b'yachid, over there, Pesach Sheni, the reason why an individual can do Pesach Sheni, mishum da'avid tzibur b'rishon, that's because the tzibur already took care of their Karban on Pesach Rishon. V'lo avid tzibur b'rishon, if you would have a scenario where the tzibur did not do Pesach Rishon, kagon rov tzibur zav in delohutra tumas ziva b'tzibur, let's say the majority of the tzibur was zav, and so tumas ziva is not allowed b'tzibur, umiyutan tmei mesim, and then a minority of the people were tamei mes, ein osin loes harishon v'loes hasheni, in that case, they can't do Pesach Rishon or Pesach Sheni, because again, an individual cannot do it if the tzibur is not already taken care of. But the Gemara is still not satisfied with this answer, and the Gemara asks, Meisrei, we have a question from the following Braisa. The Braisa says, Yachol lo yehi anish kares ela shayatar v'shalohaya b'derech rechoka. I might think the only people who get kares in a situation of not bringing Karban Pesach is if the person was pure, the person was not far away, the person was able to bring Karban Pesach and he didn't. But Aril, if you have an Aril, v'tamei sheretz, or somebody who's tamei sheretz, u'shar kol atzmeim, and other people who are tamei, minayin, how do you know that they get kares if they don't bring Karban Pesach? Now, again, Aril, we've already addressed. Aril is somebody who, if person could have given himself a bris milah and he didn't bring Karban Pesach, then there's kares. We said that previously. But tamei sheretz, this is a big chiddush. We're saying someone who's tamei sheretz is going to get kares, and he is obligated to be metar himself. He's obligated to purify himself, not like what we said before. So that's what the Gemara said. Any case, it says ushar kol atmei minayin tamed lomar v'ho ish. We learn out from the pasuk of v'ho ish that this tamei sheretz is going to get kares. So mi dekama hader at tamei sheretz. Now, from the fact that tamei sheretz is even listed here, kasavar in shom. Obviously, you're not allowed to shecht and do zrika on behalf of a tamei sheretz. In other words, tamei sheretz needs to purify himself. If somebody who became tamei by touching a sheretz, you're allowed to bring a Karban Pesach on his behalf while he's tamei. What do you even need to mention this for? Hainutar, that's basically someone who's pure with regard to Karban Pesach. Clearly, this person is being considered tamei with regard to Karban Pesach, and yet, Alma, we see, Even though he is not fit to bring Karban Pesach in his current state, the chiyuv is upon him, and he needs to purify himself and bring the Karban Pesach, and if he doesn't, he's going to get kares. Now, even though that's not true by a tzibur, if they would all be tamei sheretz, the halacha would be they don't need to purify themselves. They could do it in a state of tumah, because that's the whole point. We hold over here, ein shochtin v'zarkan al tamei sheretz. You're now at a shecht or duzrik on behalf of someone, an individual, is tamei sheretz. So if an individual cannot bring it in that state of tumah, the tzibur is allowed to bring it in that state of tumah. So the tzibur does not need to purify themselves in that situation, but the yachid does. So you see exactly the opposite of what we said. You see that in this situation of tumah, it is indeed upon the person, it's an obligation upon the person to purify. And this again brings us back to the question on Rabbi Eliezer, that by hazah, that should be permitted, because this person does have an obligation to purify. Let's say again, the guy is tumah meis, and he needs to do hazah. So the Gemara instead says, Elo Omar Rava, rather Rava says, Kosova Rabbi Eliezer. Rabbi Eliezer actually holds Shochtin Vizorkin al Tomei Sheretz. You're allowed to do Shrit of Karman Pesach, and you're allowed to do Zrik of a Karman Pesach on behalf of someone who's Tomei Sheretz. Vahu Adin Latomei Meis Beshvi Shalo. And the same thing is true if a person is Tomei Meis and it's the seventh day, you actually can bring it on his behalf while he is Tomei, and therefore, that's why hazah is a problem. Hazah, lamai, what does he even need to do the hazah for? L'achila, it's just to eat the Karban Pesach. But in terms of fulfilling his mitzvah, someone else can bring on his behalf. Achilas psachim lo ma'akva. Eating the Karban Pesach is not ma'akev. That's why Rabbi Eliezer does not allow the hazah. But the Gemara still says, isn't that a problem? Amar le Ravada Barabba l'Rava. Ravada Barabba said to Rav as follows. Imkein, if so, nimtza Pesach nishchat shelo lochlev. Isn't this a problem of having a Karban Pesach shechted for someone who can't eat it, which we said is problematic? Amar Lei said back to him, Shelo la'ochlav l'chola u'lezakein de lochazi. When we say it's a problem of shelo la'ochlav, that's if somebody's sick. If someone's elderly, he can't even eat it. Aval hai michza chazi, but this guy, he is able to eat it in theory. Tikunehu de lo miskan, he just hasn't been fixed. He hasn't been purified. That's not the same problem. And the Gemara continues at the two dots. Klal amar Rabbi Akiva v'chula. Rabbi Akiva had a rule. Any malacha that was able to be done before Shabbos, and again, when Erev Pesach falls out on Shabbos, you need to do it before Shabbos. You can't do it on Shabbos. Amar Rav Yehuda, Amar Rav. Rav Yehuda said in the name of Rav, Halacha k'Rabbi Akiva. The halacha is indeed like Rabbi Akiva. Utanan nabi gave mila ki'ai gavna. We have a Mishnah by Bris Mila, almost the same thing. Klal amar Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva has the following rule. Kol malacha she'efshar la'asosa me'erev Shabbos. Any malacha you could have done before Shabbos, eina doches ha'Shabbos. It does not push off Shabbos. But mila, but the Bris Mila itself, she'efshar la'asosa me'erev Shabbos. You can't do the Bris Mila before Shabbos. It's already too early for the Bris Mila. So doches ha'Shabbos, so that can push off Shabbos. You're allowed to do the Bris Mila on Shabbos, but the other things which could be done before, you have to do before. V'yomer Rav Yehuda Marav, halacha k'Rabbi Akiva. And on that Mishnah as well, Rav Yehuda says in the name of Rav, the halacha is like Rabbi Akiva. Why do we need to say it twice? Utzricha, we need both statements. D'i ashminan gabe Pesach, if we only told you by Pesach, chasam mitzvah lo dachu Shabbos, mishim delo nichrusu alea shalosh brises. When it comes to Karban Pesach, the machshirei mitzvah, those things that you could have done before Shabbos are not docha Shabbos, because you don't have 13 covenants that are applied over Karban Pesach. Avol mila, but when it comes to bris mila, de nichrusu alea shalosh brises, there are 13 brisos that are said regarding bris mila. Ema lidchik, so bris mila is so much more severe. Maybe I would say even those things that you could have done before Shabbos, you're allowed to do on Shabbos. V'iyash minan milan, if it only taught us mila, hasam hu demachshirei mitzvah lo dachu Shabbos, to lack a kares. When it comes to bris mila, it's not an issue of kares, so we don't push off machshirei mitzvah. In other words, by bris mila, it's not kares. Just because the person doesn't get the bris mila today, he can get it tomorrow. The kid's not even, it's just a baby, he's not even an adult. Avol Pesach, the ikar kares, but when it comes to Karban Pesach, there's a issue of kares over here if the Karban Pesach is not brought. Eima lidchi, I would say maybe it should push off Shabbos. Tzricha, that's why we need both statements of Rav Yehuda in the name of Rav, that the halacha is like Rabbi Akiva. And the Gemara continues with the Mishnah, Eimasai mevi chagiga ima. When do you bring the Karban Chagiga together with the Karban Pesach? Now, in general, there was a Karban Chagiga that you brought on the 14th of Nisan together with the Karban Pesach, but when is that brought? Bizman shu babachol, it's only brought when it's brought on a weekday, in other words, when Erev Pesach does not fall on Shabbos. Betahara, when everyone is tar, they're bringing impurity. If everyone is tummy and they bring a Karban Pesach betuma, they don't bring a Karban Chagiga. Uva muat. And also when there's a few, meaning in a situation where you don't have people eating a lot, so then they can have a Karban Chagiga, and then they can eat the Karban Pesach al hasova. They can eat it when they're satisfied. Rashi over here explains, Gemara will explain why this is relevant over here. What did the Mishnah have before that suddenly we're talking about the Karban Chagiga? Imo im haPesach barbo aser benisim kriyalaf the Gemara. We're talking about the Karban Chagiga that is brought with the Karban Pesach on the 14th. Bizman shabo b'chol uvetara. It's only a situation where it's a weekday where everyone's pure. The afagav de Pesach dochi Shabbos v'tumah. The idea is even though Karban Pesach pushes off Shabbos, it pushes off tumah. Chagiga lo dachi Shabbos. Chagiga is not dochi these things. Uvemuad shaya Pesach muad lachilas b'nei chabura. Bemuad means you have very little Karban Pesach that everyone's eating. There's a large group, so they're all eating a little. So what they would do is they would eat the Karban Chagiga first, and then they would eat the Karban Pesach after as a way of finishing off their satisfaction. That's considered a good achila of the Karban Pesach. So that's in a situation where you would bring a Karban Chagiga. However, if you have a situation where the Karban Pesach is being brought on Shabbos, or a situation where there's a lot of meat per person, or they're bringing it betuma, ein mevien imo chagiga. They do not bring, in that case, a Karban Chagiga with the Karban Pesach. Chagiga ha'isabah min ha'tzon, min ha'bokar, min ha'kvasim, min ha'izim, min ha'zucharim, min ha'kevos. Chagiga has much less restrictions in terms of what it can be brought from. It can be brought from sheep or cattle, from goats, male, female, doesn't matter. V'necheles l'shnei yamim v'layla echad. And it is eaten for 2 days and one night. And the Gemara says, Mai tana dekatani chagiga. What did we learn before that suddenly now we're talking about Karban Chagiga? So the Gemara says, Tana harkavaso v'havaso delo dachi Shabbos. In the previous Mishnah we said, you're not allowed to ride the animal, bring it from outside the tchum. You can't bring it in from far away. That's not docha Shabbos when Erev Pesach falls on Shabbos. The katani nami chagiga delo dachi Shabbos. So that's why we're bringing in also Karban Chagiga. It is similar to that. It's also not docha Shabbos. Just like there are certain aspects of Karban Pesach that are not docha Shabbos, Karban Chagiga in general is not docha Shabbos. V'hachi kamar, and here's what the Mishnah is saying. When do we bring the Karban Chagiga together with the Karban Pesach? Bizman shuba b'chol b'tara uvamud. You have to have the following conditions. Has to be a weekday, has to be in purity, and it has to be, again, a small amount of meat per person of Karban Pesach. Amar Ravashi, Ravashi says, Shma mina, you see from this, Chagiga sarbo asur, that when it comes to the Karban Chagiga that you bring on the 14th, and we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Ayin Amud Aleph.